Hello Inventors, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create the ant game using MIT App Inventor. So click on the new project and my project name is ant game new and click on OK. Now you can see that's our first screen of our game. So I'm going to just change first the thing is like that the title of my screen. So click on the screen and in the right side you will see in the bottom the screen name 1. So just say ant game like this. Okay. Now we need to design our game. So first of all, we'll create a start game screen. Okay. So I'm going to use here one layout. In the left side, you'll find the layout option and you'll see the vertical arrangement. Just drag and drop this and make sure that should be height fill parent and the width is also fill parent like this. Now click on the user interface and just drag and drop one button. And now we need to click on the vertical arrangement and make this component in the center. So for that, align horizontal should be center and the vertical also center. Now I need one image, background image of that vertical arrangement. So you can choose any image. So I'm going to add one image here. Click on the image option, upload file and choose file. And this okay. And I'm going to add one button image also. So click on the button and the right side you will find the image option. Click on this and click on upload file and click on okay. And as you can see here that I have just uploaded the image. This one is like very big, so I'm gonna just make this height and width is like some in pixel is like I'm gonna make this 100 pixel height and the width is around 200 pixel. I'm gonna remove the text from that button like this, and as you can see here, that's our first screen. So whenever someone click on this play button, so we need to open our game and we need to start our game. So we need here one more vertical arrangement and we'll hide that vertical arrangement. Okay. So just hide this visible off and drag and drop one more layout, just this one, horizontal again, and make this also width and height is fill parent. Now we need to design our game, okay? So I'm gonna add here canvas. In the left side, you'll find the drawing animation and see the canvas. This is our the main canvas where we will play the game. I'm gonna make this height and width is fill parent. Now we need to do one more thing here. In the left side, you'll find the user interface. And I need here one more layout, click on layout and see the horizontal arrangement. Why I needed this? I need this to display the score, okay? Make this width is fill parent. And make sure this vertical horizontal arrangement width should be or height should be at least 10%. Like this. Click on user interface and drag and drop one label here like this and just change that text name to score something. Make this at least 20 pixel or 30, okay, like this, and make this in a center, like this. Change the background color of this horizontal arrangement to something orange, and I'm gonna use here one more label to display the score. Define the zero value to this label and make sure this font size should be at least 30, like this. Cool. Now we need some ants. Okay. So for that, in the left side, you'll find the drawing animation again and you'll see the image spread. So just drag and drop one image spread here. And I'm going to upload one ant image here. So click on the upload file, click on choose file. And I need to make that image should be height and width is around some height. Like let's make it 100 pixel and width is around 50 pixel. So we have uploaded the image, but we need to set this. So click on the image spread and just click on the picture. And see that PNG image. So we have one ant here. Now I need to add multiple ants here. So we just need to copy and paste. We don't need to add the multiple images here. We just need to copy paste that image spread. So use the Control C or Command C and just use the Control V or Command V like this. Okay. Like see this. I need more images like this. You can add multiple ants here. Okay. Now I'm going to add only the 5 ants here. Cool. Now this is our design, but we need here some sensors. Like we need here a timer because we need to increase the speed of that ants. Okay. So how we can do this? So in the left side, you find the sensors. I'm going to use here the clock component like this. We need here one more component to display the notification. So we need a notifier. Click on user interface and just drag and drop the notifier also. I'm going to add one sound also. Okay. So I need a sound component also. In the left side, you will find the media and see the sound. So now we have all the components, but where is the sound? So we see the sound and there's nothing. So I'm gonna add upload one sound. I already have one sound here. See this sound. Okay, I'm gonna add that sound. So click on upload file, click on choose file and okay. So whenever someone, you know, hit that and so we need to play that sound, okay, like this. Now this is done. This is, now we need to use here. So now we need to just hide this vertical arrangement second one, okay, just hide this and make sure that should be enabled first one, like this. Now whenever someone click on this play button, it means which button? This is the button one. Then we need to hide that arrangement and we need to open the another arrangement, okay. So go to the block, someone click on the button one, okay. So we need to hide this vertical arrangement, visible should be false, just type false like this. And then just copy paste this and make sure change that vertical arrangement to 2 and make this true, like this, 2 and true, got it? Now we are on the game screen, okay, and this screen will look like this here, and we need to hide this also, so this will automatically hide like this. Now we need to move our ants, okay. So how we will do that? So it's very simple, that we need to do some logics here. Okay, so first of all, we need to create variables. Okay, so what I'll do, I'm gonna use the variable, and that variable name is ants spirit, image spirit. Okay, ants image, and that is the, you can say, is the null right now. So now for that, just click on the list, and you see the make a list. Try and drop this. Now we have some image spread because we need to apply a lot of, you know, properties to the all the image spreads. So we need to create one list so we can apply all the you know, whatever you want to apply, like if you want to apply the speed, so you can apply it, okay, easily in all. So like this, we have 5 images. Otherwise we need to do it, you know, one by one. So that's why I'm using here variables like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, like this. So I'm gonna just change the image split 2, 3, 4, and 5, like this. Now whenever we need to start move or you know all these ants, so once the people click on the play button, we need to start moving these, you know, ants. But make sure in the default that will move in this direction, okay. So how we'll move it, and how we'll move it in the top direction? So first we need to move ants. So for that we need to use here the speed. So you'll see here image split, and you'll see here one option is set image split speed. You'll see the component called this. So we need to set image split speed. If I will just set that image split to the 10 or 5 or 2 or 3, so this will start moving. But we need to set it for the all image split. So that's why we created here one global variable list, okay, image aren't image list. So we need to apply this. So we need to create one procedure. So I'm going to add this procedure like this, and I'm going to apply this properties in the all images. So how we'll do that? In the bottom, you'll see the any component. Just click on the plus icon, it'll see the image split. So any image split. So we need to set the speed. So you'll see the set speed option here, speed. So set image split of component. So which component, from which component? So we need to use a list. So I'm going to use here the loop, click on control, it'll see the for each loop, this one. So I'm going to add for each loop. Under that loop, I'm going to use that image split, and for each we need to add a list. So which is the list? This is the list. Now list, and which component? This is the item, okay, and 2. So what we need to set? I'm going to set to the 3. Got it? Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to create one variable here, okay, and that variable name is speed, and I'm going to assign that value to suppose 3 in initial stage. So I'm going to add this variable here. So whenever I want to increase that speed, so I need to assign that value, and I need to call this procedure here only. So this is the speed procedure. So speed and speed. Got it? So how I can call this? Click on the procedure and see the ant. So once I click on the button one, so we need to call this procedure. Okay, I'm gonna use that button like this. So So this will assign, and this will start, you know, moving, your image speed will start moving. Okay. So this is the part. Now go to the design, you'll see the image speed this, but this will start moving to the this direction. So we need to make it in the top. So for that bottom, you'll see the heading option. So make sure that should be 90. If you will assign the 90, so that will move to the top. Okay. Like this, this will move like this. Okay. So we need to assign the heading value to the all, you know, image speed. So you can just assign from here 90 90 90 90. Okay, all the images we have assigned. Got it. So this is the simple. Now in the next part, we will learn how we can kill and how we can hit the image spread, and how we can get the score, how we can increase the score, and how we can create the game over screen. You will get another part link in the description. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.